Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through some equivalence laws. Guys, these laws will not be directly, mostly they will not be asked directly in the exam. But you need to know guys, because while solving problems, we will be using all these laws. So that is the reason why just to go through them. So you can verify any of these laws by using any kind of truth table logics guys. So just draw truth tables and you verify whether they are matching or not. Okay, so idempotency law. Idempotency is nothing but P, V, P is nothing but P. P or P, it is not V guys, it is R. P or P, R only, right? Let me recheck because P or P, okay, fine. Okay, and commutative law. I hope everyone knows commutative law. A plus B is equals to B plus A, like that. So P or Q is equals to Q or P. P and Q is Q and P. P implies Q is not equal guys. So that's the reason why I have just skipped it. So P double implies Q is equals to Q double implies P, yes. Associative law. Guys, please remember this associative and distributive laws, guys. Because these two we will be using in conversions of few problems. So please note them down somewhere. So basically here, if you observe, all are V's only. Here all are ands only. V is nothing but OR, guys. All ORs and all ANDs. So you can change the brackets, guys. So that's possible. Okay. Distributive law, please remember it, guys. So practice in this way. So if you want to do distribution for this, write initially P and write the next symbol, write the first letter, close it, write the middle one, write the first letter, write the second symbol and write the last one. So this, this and this, this, this and this, in center this, fine. So if you remember already, it's okay. But if you are in a bit confusion, please remember in this way, because I remember in that way only. Okay. After that, De Morgan's law, remember that guys, De Morgan's law is nothing but negation of something. So if you apply negation of a P, V, Q, V means OR guys, P or Q, it becomes negation of P and negation of Q. So negation will be applied for P, negation will be applied for OR, negation will be applied for Q. For P, it becomes negative P, that's nothing but not P and not Q. For OR, it becomes AND, for AND becomes it OR. Fine? Okay. So let us continue. So remember this thing also guys. So the double implication and I think I have written it wrong. Okay, sorry. This is single implication. This is double implication. Perfect. So basically single implication gives the result in this way guys. P implies Q is nothing but negation of PVQ. Guys, please remember this guys. It's really important guys, because we'll be using in problems. Please remember. Okay. So biconditional elements, elimination. So double implies means you can write it in this way. P implies Q and Q implies P. Fine. Okay. So observative law. So this is really simple guys. P, P. V, P and Q will be P and P, V, Q will be P. Please remember these two also. These are not so used, but if possible, they may give a question. Okay. So contrapositive. Contrapositive is nothing but if P is equals to Q, then negation of Q is equals to negation of P, or negation of P equal to negation of Q. Fine. Okay. So after that, we are having double negation. Remember this also. So double negation is negation of P is nothing but P. Okay. So these are the few fundamental things guys, like P, V, negation of P equal to true. PV negation of P equal to 3, true. Guys, whenever you are facing these kind of things, please draw the truth table guys, so that it will be really easy. You're gonna get all truths. You'll be getting exact P combination, exact false combination. If you can remember, you can remember guys. But basically I try to draw a truth table so that basically if I remember, I'll be doing wrongs. So that's the reason why I will be trying to remember the main logic. Okay. So there are a few more things guys. So basically whenever a truth table is getting all truths, like the result. So all truths means tautology and all false means contradiction. So neither tautology nor contradiction means contingency. Contingency is nothing but the combination of true and false, which we get normally. Okay. So along with the truth tables, we can also represent in these four ways guys. Those are nothing but natural deduction system, axiomatic system, semantic table method and resolution reflections. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the natural reduction system. Thank you. Thanks for watching.